Standing by the towering 15 feet high solid oak front door, Prince Andrew gives a nod and a cheery wave to the pretty brunette as she leaves the £63 million Manhattan mansion. He appears entirely at ease but then, for a split second, glances around the door as if to check that no one had witnessed the brief encounter. As well he might. For these exclusive pictures come from a never-before-seen video of the Duke of York staying at the New York home of convicted pedophile Jeffrey Epstein. And some of the other images caught on camera make for disturbing viewing. The footage of the Duke of York, then the UK's special representative for international trade, was taken less than an hour after Epstein, who had been convicted of sex with a child in 2008, left the house in the company of a young, shivering blonde woman. The video was shot on December 6, 2010, during a visit by the prince to Epstein's nine-story 21,000-square-foot mansion dubbed the House of Horrors by many of his young victims. By then Epstein, who took his own life last weekend, was on a child sex offender register, yet one observer told the Mail on Sunday that several of the women leaving and entering the home while Andrew was apparently inside looked very young indeed. The Duke has vehemently denied claims by Epstein's alleged sex slave Virginia Roberts that she had sex with the prince on three occasions, the first when she was 17 and once at the US millionaire's now notorious 40-room mansion at 9 East 71st Street in Manhattan, the setting of these pictures. Her allegations, submitted to a court in 2014, were later thrown out by a judge who ordered them to be struck from the record as immaterial and impertinent. Since Epstein's suicide last weekend as he faced further child sex trafficking charges, Buckingham Palace has repeated its denial of wrongdoing by the prince. Any suggestion of impropriety with underage minors is categorically untrue. It is emphatically denied that the Duke of York had any form of sexual contact or relationship with Virginia Roberts, it said. Any claim to the contrary is false and without foundation. The Queen also made a public show of support by allowing Prince Andrew to sit next to her as they were driven to a church service near Balmoral last Sunday. However, these images are sure to raise fresh questions about the 59-year-old's judgment as they place him inside the private, inner sanctum of Epstein, who continued to abuse young girls even after a controversial 2008 plea deal that saw him serve just 13 months, much of it on day release. The prince looked entirely at ease in Epstein's house, a source told the Mail on Sunday last night. There were girls coming and going. One, who came out of the house with Epstein about an hour before Prince Andrew said goodbye to the brunette, was tiny and shivering. It was a particularly cold New York December day. What I remember most is the constant procession of girls and women going to and from the house. It was chilling to see. Everyone knew by that point that Epstein was a convicted pedophile, yet he was flaunting his lifestyle in plain sight. When the prince came to the door I was stunned. He looked totally at ease. He said a few words to the girl, who was very pretty, and then she walked off down the street in the direction of Central Park. If I hadn't known it was Prince Andrew, I would have thought he owned the place. He looked so comfortable and relaxed as he stood there at the door. He didn't appear to have a concern in the world as he smiled and waved goodbye to the girl. It was only as the girl walked off that he glanced around the doorframe, almost as if to check no one was watching. The video was taken less than 24 hours after the prince was infamously photographed walking through Central Park with Epstein. He had met the US businessman through Ghislaine Maxwell, the daughter of disgraced tycoon Robert Maxwell and a woman the FBI says is now of renewed interest in its ongoing case into allegations made by scores of women that they were sexually abused by Epstein and his wealthy friends at homes in London, New Mexico, New York, and the US Virgin Islands. Ms. Maxwell has repeatedly denied that she acted as a madam for Epstein and has described Ms. Roberts's claims as malicious lies. Epstein's New York home was as weird and twisted as the man himself. The entry foyer where Prince Andrew stood to wave off the brunette was decorated, according to an account by writer Vicky Ward in Vanity Fair magazine, with row upon row of individually framed artificial eyeballs, imported from England. The video footage shows the initials JE in raised brass letters on the wall next to the front door. What is not seen is the heating element that Epstein had installed beneath the concrete pavement to melt the New York winter snow. On a wall in the hall was a bizarre portrait of former U.S. President Bill Clinton in red heels and the infamous stained blue dress worn by Monica Lewinsky when she performed a sex act on him. Nearby hung a giant painting of Epstein inside a prison surrounded by barbed wire and gun-toting guards. The disgraced financier reportedly said the artwork was to remind me that I could go back to prison anytime. A chandelier had a life-size female doll hanging from it, and one woman who claims to have been assaulted by Epstein said a bathroom had prosthetic breasts on the wall so he could play with the nipples as he took a bath. Dozens of photographs of Epstein with his famous friends, including Bill and Hillary Clinton, Saudi Arabia's Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman and filmmaker Woody Allen, were on display in his study beside a life-size stuffed tiger and a stuffed gray poodle. One can only wonder how Andrew missed the procession of women or the signs of Epstein's sexual deviance. Indeed, Epstein's pride and joy was a large human chessboard at the bottom of the main staircase which had customized figurines modeled on his female staff members wearing suggestive clothing. Then there was the life-size statue of a naked African warrior. Not to mention the leather room. When the FBI raided the house after Epstein was arrested last month, it reportedly found thousands of indecent images of underage women on computer hard drives locked in his office safe. Others have claimed that Epstein had photographs and videos of his famous friends engaged in sex acts which have now been seized by the FBI, prompting conspiracy theories that Epstein was murdered despite official autopsy results released on Friday stating definitively that the cause of death was suicide. The video obtained by the Mail on Sunday is particularly shocking for the fact that, even 2 years after his 2008 child sex conviction, Epstein was seemingly flaunting his penchant for young women in plain view and in the middle of one of the busiest cities in the world. The footage begins just before 2:30 p.m. on December 6, 2010, as two security men leave Epstein's mansion and chat to another security man in a waiting Chrysler. Epstein's black Bentley arrives in the street about 20 minutes later, shortly before a delivery man from L.E. Gourmet delivers a parcel. Shortly after 3:10 p.m., an unidentified young woman in a red beanie hat leaves the house. She heads in the direction of East 66th Street, where Epstein owned a flat and where, according to some alleged victims, he kept young Eastern European girls as virtual prisoners. About 25 minutes later, an older, professional-looking woman with blonde hair leaves the house. 1 minute later, at 3:35 p.m., Epstein, wearing a thick white fur-lined winter coat, leaves his property, followed by a young-looking girl dressed in a flimsy gray top. She appears to be carrying his glasses. In a deeply troubling scene, the blonde-haired woman, who barely reaches Epstein's shoulders, appears cold and shaking as she walks with the millionaire to his Bentley. Epstein clambers into the back seat as the young woman stands on the street, seemingly being given instructions. An older passerby glances at the incongruous-looking couple. After around 2 minutes, the girl jogs back to the house when she stands on the front step and presses the doorbell, visibly shaking with cold. It is opened by a professional-looking brunette woman closely resembling Sarah Kellen, Epstein's former assistant whom several alleged victims have dubbed the co-conspirator in Epstein's crimes. Kellen, who is now married to a U.S. race car driver called Brian Vickers, has never commented publicly about the Epstein case. However, she appeared in court during a defamation suit brought by Ms. Roberts against Ms. Maxwell and pleaded the fifth when asked about her role in Epstein's sex trafficking scheme. In America, invoking the Fifth Amendment is a legal term which means you do not have to give evidence that might incriminate you. At 4:30 p.m., the door opens and a pretty brunette emerges. She pauses and turns back to the house where Prince Andrew can be seen at the door. The pair chat for a few seconds before the woman walks away, leaving Andrew to glance up the street before closing the door. 40 minutes later, as the light begins to fade, another young-looking dark-haired woman arrives at the house. In an unpublished manuscript released in the U.S. as part of a huge trove of documents related to a defamation suit brought by Ms. Roberts against Ms. Maxwell, which was subsequently settled, Ms. Roberts talks about meeting Prince Andrew in Epstein's New York home. She gives an account, supported by another alleged victim, of how the prince sat on a sofa and posed with a spitting image puppet of himself. "When Andrew cupped my breast with a doll made in his image, I only giggled away," she wrote in the book, described in court documents as a fictionalized account of her life. Last night, the source of the video said they had decided to go public with the footage to encourage further victims to come forward. "I'm haunted by the shivering young girl who was with Epstein. What became of her?" asked the source. "Now I'm reading everything that went on inside and know the full horrors of what went on. I'm wondering, was she a victim too?" This weekend, Prince Andrew was relaxing in the sunshine in Spain on a holiday with his ex-wife Sarah Ferguson. The source said, when the video was taken he looked like a man without a care in the world. You have to wonder if that's still the case. So many disturbing questions. It's time Andrew answered them, royal author Angela Levin on how the prince must disclose everything he knows about Jeffrey Epstein. By Angela Levin for the Mail on Sunday. The last time we saw Prince Andrew, he was stepping off a flight to Malaga in the company of his former wife Sarah Ferguson before taking a limousine to the luxury resort of Soto Grande. Business as usual, in other words. Andrew will be glad of the chance to get away from it all, no doubt, as friends say he has been unusually stressed of late, and no wonder. For the 59-year-old is once again in the spotlight over his close friendship with convicted sex offender Jeffrey Epstein. Only days before Epstein's prison suicide, a number of legal documents had been unsealed by the U.S. courts, and one of these included lurid allegations about Prince Andrew's conduct with a 17-year-old girl, something he has always denied. Last week, his lawyers repeated the same brief formula they have stuck to all along. It is emphatically denied that the Duke of York had any form of sexual contact or relationship with Virginia Roberts. Any claim to the contrary is false and without foundation. No doubt they are correct. Yet hiding behind lawyers is no longer enough for Prince Andrew, a father of two daughters and a man who holds a pivotal place in British national life. Day by day, the evidence of Epstein's nauseating crimes mounts up, and the true extent of Andrew's friendship with Epstein grows ever clearer. The shocking video evidence in today's Mail on Sunday makes it all too plain the prince remained on friendly terms with Epstein even when it was obvious just what sort of man he was. This was no brief acquaintance. They had known each other for some time, ever since Epstein's former lover and alleged fixer Ghislaine Maxwell introduced them in the 1990s. The prince became a regular guest at Epstein's celebrity-filled dinner parties in Manhattan and, as their friendship grew, the invitations were returned. In June 2000, Epstein and Ghislaine attended the Dance of the Decades, a spectacular party at Windsor Castle hosted by the Queen to mark Andrew's 40th, Princess Anne's 50th, Princess Margaret's 70th and Prince William's 18th birthdays. In the autumn of that year, Andrew flew to New York and attended a Halloween hookers and bondage party in Manhattan, where Ghislaine dressed as a prostitute. In December of the same year, Andrew threw a birthday bash for Ghislaine at Sandringham, which Epstein attended before all three went to Phuket in Thailand, to celebrate the new year. Andrew was snapped sunbathing on a yacht with topless young women. The criminal nature of Epstein's interest in very young women became clear when this newspaper revealed the shocking case of Virginia Roberts, who says she had been recruited to work as a 15-year-old masseuse for Epstein and had been treated as the billionaire's sex slave. There is an infamous photograph from early 2001, believed to have been taken in Ghislaine's Belgravia home, which shows Andrew with his arm around the bare midriff of Ms. Roberts, while Ghislaine is grinning in the background. It is all the more worrying, then, that Ms. Roberts, who is now a mother of three living in Australia, claims she witnessed Epstein having sex with underage girls on a daily basis. Still worse, Ms. Roberts has alleged Epstein forced her to have sex with Andrew in London and on two other occasions when she was 17. There has been no claim that Andrew was aware she had been acting under duress, and in any case he denies that any such incidents happened at all. It is important to stress also that an American judge threw out the allegations against the prince and ordered them to be struck from the record as immaterial and impertinent. In another of the witness statements now open to the public, alleged Epstein victim Johanna Schoberg claims Andrew touched her breast while sitting on a couch at Epstein's New York apartment in 2001. The prince continues to vehemently deny all such claims, but what is beyond doubt is that shortly after Epstein was released from jail for child sex offenses, his old friend came to stay. A now familiar photo of the pair strolling through Central Park showed a level of misjudgment which we simply would never expect from our royals. The Moses exclusive clip of Andrew grinning as he waves goodbye to an unidentified brunette from behind Epstein's oak door underlines just how close the pair were. In the minutes before Andrew appears at the door, women are seen coming and going from the mansion, many of them questionably young in appearance. Was Andrew aware? Did he ask no questions? Epstein had just been released from a prison sentence for abuse, after all. It has been reported Epstein paraded his sexual perversions in his homes with naked photos of young girls and soaps in the shape of male and female genitals. Did Andrew see any of this? If so, why did he continue the friendship? It is clear there are serious questions that need answers, and it's high time we heard them. The Duke of York is not an ordinary citizen, but a senior royal and father to two grown-up princesses. He was made Britain's special trade representative on his retirement from the Royal Navy, a post he still held in 2011 when the Mose first exposed his friend. Andrew remains Commander and Honorary Vice Admiral of the Royal Navy. These enormous privileges bring great responsibility, but they don't seem to have had much effect on his social behavior. Instead, he has garnered a reputation for a self-indulgent lifestyle that includes meetings with unsavory Middle Eastern tyrants and potentates. He seems to lack self-awareness and appears unconcerned that his actions risk grave damage to the royal family. Sarah Ferguson has said, "We really believe in being good parents for our girls. In our everyday life, we really respect each other and honor each other." Yet her former husband seems unable to see any disconnect between standing proudly in morning dress for the wedding of his daughter Eugenie last October and the seedy friendship with a criminal abuser he would rather not discuss. Why has he got such a high-handed and reckless attitude? His childhood might help explain. Born in 1960, Andrew quickly became an adored second son, one who the Queen hoped would stabilize her marriage. It was said at the time Philip felt constrained by royal life and that the relationship was tense. But Andrew's arrival did the trick. It also tied in with the Queen's wish to be a more involved mother. She even wrote to her cousin Lady Mary Cambridge, "The baby is adorable. All in all, he's going to be terribly spoiled by all of us, I'm sure." Perhaps this was a sort of compensation for her earlier strictness with Charles. But the result has been unfortunate. Andrew behaves as though he is free to do exactly as he chooses. Does he not know how shocking his friendship with Epstein appears? It is time for the Duke of York to accept the serious misjudgment he has made and cooperate with authorities to disclose everything he knows about Epstein's lifestyle and actions. Has he contacted the police in Britain or America to try to help shed light on what by any standards was a horrific series of crimes committed by his former friend? It's impossible to know because Buckingham Palace refuses to say. But if he hasn't, he should. The alternative is to try yet again to bury it in soft sand, to hide away and, like a coward, hope his 93-year-old mother will make things better. Angela Levin's Harry, Conversations with the Prince is published by Bonnier.